Good morning, children. So in the last class, we had learnt about the three river basins of the Northern Plains, which were the Ganga Basin, Brahmaputra Basin, and the Satluj Basin. Today in this class, children, we will learn in detail about the two basins, the Ganga Basin and the Brahmaputra Basin. Let us first read about the Ganga Basin. The Ganga is the main river in the Northern Plains. It starts as a stream called Bhagirathi from the Gangotri Glacier in the Himalayas and flows at a high speed down the mountain slopes. On its way down, it is joined by the rivers Alaknanda and Mandakini at Devprayag. So children, the Ganga River is the main river in the Northern Plains. Which is the main river of Northern Plain? It is River Ganga. Now, River Ganga originates from Gangotri Glacier in the Himalayas, and it originates in the Himalayas as a small stream. Stream means a small river. So, River Ganga originates from the Gangotri Glacier in Himalayas as a small river known as Bhagirathi. Then, it flows down from the mountain slopes at a high speed. Now, as the Ganga River flows down from Himalayas, it is joined by many more rivers like Alaknanda and Mandakini. And all the three rivers meet at Devprayag. So Devprayag is the name of a place where River Ganga, Alaknanda and Mandakini meet. Now children, let us read the second paragraph. Ganga enters the northern plains at Haridwar. Gomti, Ghagra, Gandhak, Kosi and Son are some of the tributaries of Ganga. The Ganga and Yamuna meet at Allahabad and this place is known as Sangam. So children, River Ganga enters northern plains at Haridwar. So Haridwar is the place where River Ganga enters into the northern plains. Now, what are the tributaries of Ganga? So children, the tributaries of Ganga are Ghagra, Gomti, Gandhak, Kosi and Son. All these are the tributaries of River Ganga. Now in the previous class, children, I had explained the meaning of the word tributary. So when many small rivers come and join the main river, it is known as a tributary. So all these rivers, Gomti, Ghagra, Gandhak, Kosi and Son are the tributaries of Ganga. Now children, lastly, the River Ganga and River Yamuna meet at Allahabad and this place where these two rivers meet is known as Sangam. So what is Sangam? Sangam is a place where River Ganga and Yamuna meet. Now children, let us read the last paragraph of the Ganga Basin. The famous Kumbh Mela is held at Sangam at an interval of every 12 years. The river Son joins the Ganga near Patna. Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Ken rivers join Yamuna. In West Bengal, the Ganga flows slowly and split into two distributaries, the Hooghly and Padma. The Hooghly flows through Kolkata and Padma flows through Bangladesh where it joins Brahmaputra before entering Bay of Bengal. Finally, the Ganga reaches Bay of Bengal at Ganga Sagar. Now children, I am sure all of you must have heard of Kumbh Mela. So Kumbh Mela is held at Sangam and it is held after every 12 years. Now the river Son, which is a tributary of Ganga, joins Ganga near Patna. So River Son joins Ganga near Patna. And children, what are the tributaries of Yamuna? So the tributaries of Yamuna are Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Ken. Now children, all these rivers join River Yamuna. Now, as River Ganga reaches West Bengal, it flows slowly and splits into two distributaries. Now, what do you understand by the word split? Split means it gets divided. Splits mean divide. So, When the river Ganga reaches West Bengal, it flows slowly and then it gets divided into two distributaries, Hooghly and Padma. So Hooghly and Padma are names of rivers. Now, what do you understand by the word distributary? So children, when a larger river gets divided into smaller streams, smaller channels of water, that is only known as distributary. So as you can see here, river Ganga gets divided into two streams. First is known as Hooghly and second is known as Padma. Now children, the river Hooghly flows through Kolkata and river Padma flows through Bangladesh. So one river flows through Kolkata and the other river flows through Bangladesh, and Padma joins Brahmaputra river before these two rivers finally enter into Bay of Bengal. So children, Padma as well as Brahmaputra, these two rivers finally enter into Bay of Bengal, and river Ganga also enters Bay of Bengal at a place called Ganga Sagar. So Ganga Sagar is the name of a place where the river Ganga enters Bay of Bengal. Now children, always remember, all the rivers flow and then they finally enter into a larger sea. So all the rivers which are flowing through India, children, ultimately they will enter into a larger sea. Either they will enter into Bay of Bengal or they will enter into Arabian Sea. But all the rivers which are flowing in India, they will finally enter into a larger sea. Now let us read about Brahmaputra Basin. So the Brahmaputra is the longest of the three rivers of North India. It starts in Tibet. It is called Tsangpo there. It enters India through Arunachal Pradesh and flows through Assam before entering Bangladesh. The Ganga and Brahmaputra, before falling into Bay of Bengal, forms the largest delta in the world. It is called the Sundarbans. So children, Brahmaputra is the longest river among the Ganga, Brahmaputra and Satluj. So which is the longest river of North India? Brahmaputra is the longest river of North India. And children, Brahmaputra, it starts in Tibet. So in Tibet, Brahmaputra starts, and in Tibet, this river is known as Tsangpo. So it is pronounced as Tsangpo and T is silent. So it is Tsangpo. Now children, Brahmaputra rivers enter India through Arunachal Pradesh. So in India, Brahmaputra enters through Arunachal Pradesh, then it flows through Assam, and then lastly it enters into Bangladesh, which is our neighboring country. So before entering into Bangladesh, children, in India, Brahmaputra flows through two states. It flows through Arunachal Pradesh and it also flows through Assam. And then after flowing through Assam, it finally enters into Bangladesh. Now children, before this river fall into Bay of Bengal, both Ganga and Brahmaputra forms the world's largest delta, which is known as Sundarbans Delta. Now children, what do you mean by the word delta? A delta is an area of low flat land. So delta is an area of low and flat land, and it is triangular in shape. So this is a triangle piece of land. Now when a river splits and spreads out into several branches before entering the sea, a delta is formed. So a delta is an area of low flat land. It is a triangular land, and when a river splits and spreads out into several branches before entering the sea, this piece of land is only known as delta. So which is the world's largest delta? It is Sundarbans Delta. And which are the two rivers which make this delta? Ganga and Brahmaputra. Now children, let us read the last paragraph. Heavy rains during the rainy season causes floods. The Brahmaputra basin is surrounded by Garo, Khasi and Naga hills. The main towns are Guwahati, Shillong and Dispur. So children, due to heavy rain during the rainy season, this river gets flooded. This river gets overflowed. And the Brahmaputra basin, children, is surrounded by many hills. So it is surrounded by Garo, Khasi and Naga hills. And it is also surrounded by some towns. So the towns are Guwahati, Shillong and Dispur. So Brahmaputra basin is surrounded by these towns. Now children, I will show you. This is the Sundarbans Delta. The green colored portion that you see, children, this is the Sundarbans Delta, which is the largest delta in the world. And it is formed by two rivers, River Ganga and River Brahmaputra. So this is the Sundarbans Delta. Now children, let us read this. Did you know? The Sundarbans get its name from Sundari trees that grow there. So this is important, children. Question can be asked from here. So Sundarbans has got its name from Sundari tree. So Sundari is the name of a tree that grows in this area. And from Sundari tree only, the Sundarbans has got its name. So children, today we will do till here only. About Satluj Basin and Ganga Action Plan, we will read in the next class. So children, please revise the portion that we have done today, and I will see you in the next class. Thank you, children.